I'm with Andrea Vasiliou. How are you, Andrea?
I'm really well, thank you. How are you?
I'm very good. Very excited to watch the movie.
Oh, me too. I'm super excited. I can't wait to see it. It's been a long time coming, so it's going to be really exciting to watch it.
Can you tell us about your character in the movie?
Okay, so Froina is part of the Katori tribe, and she's part of an all-female warrior group, and she is in search of some justice for her land. So she is fights with Dimia, and she does a lot of like bow and arrow action, and you know, there's a lot of dragons involved and zombie has to kill a lot of zombies, so it's a lot of fun playing her character.
Sounds good. What was your biggest challenge doing this movie?
I think the biggest challenge was some of the fight sequences, because I fought with a dagger as well as with my bow. Uh-huh. So it was learning all the choreography and also doing things from height as well. So we did stuff in the castle, looking down and kind of aiming for fury monsters, which are like the zombies. So that was quite a challenge, learning those skills, but it was really, really fun. You shouldn't miss this movie, because it is totally action-packed and it's so much fun to watch. It's going to be amazing. If you want drama, if you want killing, if you want action, and if you want like lots of different characters, then definitely watch this movie. If you love The Walking Dead and Game of Thrones, then you're going to love this.
Sounds like a good plan. Thank you so much, Andrea, enjoy your night.
Thank you. Thanks.
For your character.
Yeah, well, I'm Jean-Paul Gates, and I play the character of Prince Favian.
Mm-hmm.
So, as I was explaining to the lovely lady over there, if you remember Joaquin Phoenix in Gladiator, and he's alienated because his father is not going to pass to him the kingdom.
Uh-huh.
So he kind of seeks revenge,
you know,
which will all be revealed when you see the film. You know what I mean? So, it's great. It's great. I mean, I love wearing, you know, period costumes, because it's almost like doing theatre again. You know what I mean? I haven't done theatre for a long time, so it was great to get back into those frocks and tights and all that kind of thing. But yeah, it was fun. It was fun. And you'll have to excuse me, because I'm kind of like half dead at the moment, because I've got flu. So you know.
Oh.
So yeah.
Sorry about that.
It's all right. It's all right. It's all right.
How was your preparation for this role?
Well, I've played. I've not really played that many royal figures before, but in essence, really, it's really, you know, realizing that when you play a royal, you know, the time it's all about slowness, you know, and being regal. But more importantly, it's in essence being, I suppose, how can I put this? See, I'm losing my train of thought here, because, you know, but in essence, really, a lot of monarchs, you know, if we're talking like 15th, 16th century, what they were good at, they were good at backgammon, they were good at chess, that kind of thing. And he's quite a tactician. So even though he doesn't get involved in the military things, you know, he's quite a tactician. So that's really important. So I kind of like play a bit of chess and backgammon, even though I did not have to play that in the movie. So it just got me into the mindset of being, being tactitor, you know what I mean?
Cool.
You know, so, and also, you know, they, as you know, they had quite a few mistresses. Although in this particular movie, I don't get a mistress. Can you believe that?
Wow.
I talked to Ben about that, but anyway. But he's, you'll see in the movie that he really detests his sister, because his sister is going to be given the kingdom. You know, it's a low-budget version of Lord of the Rings meets Excalibur. For me, it's part of a trilogy. And I think, you know, to be done on this kind of budget, I mean, both Simon and Ben have done a fantastic job, really, to be honest with you. And I'm proud to be associated with it, you know. So, if people want to go out and watch a movie that's accessible, doesn't it have names, no doubt. But then again, Lord of the Rings, really, in essence, started, it didn't have names.
Yeah.
And their attention to detail with the creatures they've created is really great. And the special effects are awesome. So, you know, I'm bound to say that, aren't I? You know.
What's your next project?
Oh, right. Well, I'm doing a political film, actually, called Election Nights. I've got two of the movies coming out, one called The Doll Master in September, which is a British version of Chucky. And then I played Dr. Frankenstein in a movie called The Howling that comes out in October. So quite busy, yeah.
Cool. You know, so. Where can we find out more about you?
Well, I've got a website, johnpaulgates.com, or go on IMDb and put in johnpaulgates.com. And remember, that's no relation to Bill, although I am trying to work on it. And John as in without the H. Yeah.
Cool. Well, enjoy tonight. It's your night. So
thank you so much. Hasta mañana.
Yeah? What are you expecting about the movie tonight?
Well, it's the first of three, so I'm expecting it to be left open-ended, but I'm expecting a lot of action and an interesting storyline. So yeah, looking forward to it.
Can you tell us about your next future character?
So I come into film two, and I'm a hybrid. I'm half man, half lizard.
Wow.
And I rule the Dark Kingdom, and the second film's called The Dark Kingdom.
Uh-huh.
And so my interaction is with the main characters, and I can't say too much because I'm very much leads into film three.
Uh-huh.
But they spend some time in my kingdom.
Cool. Can you tell us, how did you prepare for this role?
Initially, understanding how a lizard, you know, operates, how it works under pressure, how it's quite still,
uh-huh,
but obviously cold-blooded. And then understanding what my wants are. Who am I? Where am I? What do I want? What am I trying to achieve? And then worrying about the dialogue. And then bring it all together.
Cool.
So,
how has been working with Simon Wells?
It was fantastic. Yeah. Simon gave me a lot of room. And so, you know, he gave me a nudge when he needed to. But a lot of times he would see what I was doing and be like, I'm really happy with that, nothing to say. So, and I get, that comes from preparing.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, I'm there to do my job and to do it to my best of my abilities, and to deliver to the director and the production. So,
cool.
Yeah, it was good, enjoyed it. Look, fantasy is wonderful, right? I mean, I grew up on Dungeons & Dragons playing the board game, so I think to just step out sometimes of reality and to immerse yourself in a make-believe world is just, you know, it's important.
Yeah.
Because life is hard, you know?
It is indeed,
and I think it's just so nice sometimes just to have a break and
and
be entertained.
Yeah.
And, so I think it's very important to have some fantasy, some imagination, you know, in our lives.
Cool. And next future projects?
I'm going to LA. I'm going on to an American series, but I can't say too much about that. I've just finished on an American series before this in Prague called Nightfall, which is a Knights Templar, huge production, produced by Jeremy Renner, the actor, and the writer's Dominic Minghella. So a very, very big production, 10 episodes, launching early next year. It's going to be amazing. It's called Nightfall, so look out for that.
I will.
Yeah.
I will.
But it's, so that's kind of what I'm up to at the moment. So I'm here for a couple of weeks and I go to LA, back to work.
Cool. Sounds like a good plan on a busy agenda.
Trying to keep busy.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you. Pleasure. Ips, how are you tonight?
I am very well, thank you, Miguel. I'm very excited to see the film tonight.
Cool.
It's got to be lots of action, I hear.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I'm very excited too. So apparently it has dragons, zombies, mermaids.
All the good stuff.
Exactly.
All the good
stuff. Yeah.
I mean, I like lots of comedies, so this is quite a lot of action for me, but I'm also really into my fantastical films, so I love Game of Thrones-esque type things. I love witches and wizards and dragons. So I think with a lot of fighting and quite a lot of action, it's going to be a good one.
Cool. I liked your outfit, by the way.
Thank you.
Where did you get this from, the jacket?
The dress is Millie, and this is, I think it's the same. It's a Millie. So it's a very cool designer, British, which is great. Got to support all the locals.
Of course.
I just thought I'll throw it all together and see what works.
Yeah, cool. And last thing, where can we find out more about you? Social media,
so at Pips_Taylor on Instagram. That's mainly where I am and what I'm doing.
Uh-huh.
Lots of kind of like music, DJing, radio, cooking, that kind of stuff.
Wow.
So, yeah.
A variety of nice things, right?
Just my weird little life.
Yeah, exactly. Well, Pips, enjoy tonight and have so much fun.
Yeah, me
too.
Thank you very much.
Mark Summit, how are you?
I'm very good, thank you. I'm very good.
Tell us more about your role, your character.
So I play a character called Bryce. He's a village bully, what the townsmen, he runs the town, so he's like known as a townsman. And basically the knights step in his territory and he doesn't really like it, so he kind of tries to show his strength, but doesn't quite work out. I don't want to ruin anything, but you'll see what happens. Why shouldn't they? Do you like dragons?
I love dragons.
Do you like zombies?
I love zombies.
Do you like random things?
Yeah.
Then you'll love this then.
sounds good. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Sounds like a good mixture.
Yeah, yeah.
How's working with Simon Wells?
Simon is a very, very lovely man. I first met Simon on, obviously, Knights of the Damned, and then we've been recently working on Order of the Kings. We get on really well. We've got a good chemistry with each other. So because of that, he's very comfortable telling me when he doesn't like something or when he does like something.
Uh-huh.
And pretty much he's always coming up to me, praising me when I'm doing a good job. And he finds me funny on set, and I find him funny.
Cool.
And it's brother love. It's a lot of brother love.
And what about the rest of the cast?
The cast, I love everyone. I think they're all awesome, yeah. Ben, he's put in a very, very, a lot of work into this film. He's put a lot of work into this film. The cast and the crew, they've all been dedicated, very talented people as well, especially with the stunts, the combat stuff as well. Everyone's great. I love them all. I love them all, yeah.
How did you prepare for this particular role?
I got drunk. No, joking. No, I didn't. So obviously with Bryce in Knights of the Damned, he hasn't got a big part in this part of the film, but in Order of the Kings he did have more, and it was more because obviously everyone else is more kind of doing stunt fighting and things like that, and when I read the scripts I was like, Bryce can't even fight, so I just had to sit there and be lazy and prepare for him character, have this kind of monument, because I didn't want to come on set and be like very, very good at the combat when his character's not like that. He's very kind of, he's a clumsy one, if that makes sense. He's
cool.
The kind of one that is very unpredictable and doesn't really deliver how he should deliver, so yeah.
Cool. And now talking more about your future projects, what's next?
So I've got my feature film that I'm doing called Homeless Ashes that I'm very, very excited for. I'm producing, directing and starring in. So it's a lot to take on. I've also got Pegasus Bridge with Lance Nielsen, what's coming up. And that's pretty much what's in the pipeline at the moment. So yeah,
just
hopefully see what comes in. I've just been, I can't say much, but there's a film in Canada called Hostage that have shown a spike of interest in me. So we'll see what happens there. But yeah, Homeless Ashes is the main focus at the moment, so yeah.
Cool, sounds good. Where can we find out more about you? Social media?
So I live on Tooting Broadway. No, I'm joking. No, it's,
I still live in Clapham South.
there we go, neighbours. You can find me on Twitter, Mark Zammit, what's spelled MarkZammit.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously when you put it in, it'll just come up, so yeah.
Cool.
And you just look out for a guy that looks like a wannabe four.
I
love you, viewers.
Oh,
you're all amazing. We all need to go on a date and have a big bear
hug. Exactly. Tooting Broadway.
Tooting Broadway, Clapham.
Clapham
South.
Thank you so much.
Thank you,
enjoy
you
your night, okay?
Thank you.
You.